The prophets have spoken, friends. The dragon's return is nigh. Join the honorable Duke's ranks and help us be rid of the fell beast. The day's come to lay down rod and reel and take up the sword.
It's the dragon!
Get to the boat!
For your lives, go!
Take a bar!
Thank you.
You say it left a glowing scar?
Yes. The wound has closed, and it seems the worst has passed, but his heart lies silent.
If you would face me...
You are sure of this?
Yes.
Ill magic. The work of some curse. The whole world's already gone mad for fear of this dragon. Won't no good come of this. I must go see to the others, Kina. Tell me if aught changes here.
All right. You should be abed. I wish you would not strain yourself so. I am worried for you, Cuz.
That man you are speaking with, he's of the Pawn Legion. They come from some unknown place, just appear without a warning. They are a strange lot. Not human, quite. They look the part, sure enough, but they lack the will, the spark, what drives us. They have no capacity to feel nor act alone, so they live as sellswords. Myrmidons, they're called. There's an encampment west of the village where men gather to face the dragon. I'd wager a fair number of his kind will be there as well. Why don't you take him? Might be you learn aught of why he came to you in the first place.
Damn beast!
Too close. I'm called Reynard, a traveling salesman, though those damnable beasts ruined my wares. But thanks to you, it was only wares I lost. I'll consider it a bargain. You have my thanks.
We've arrived, Master.
Beast comes! Hurry!
Oh.
the port. It's our chance. Attack its leg.
Our fealty is sworn to you, Arisen. From this day, the Legion's men call pawns live and die by your command.
I am Mercedes. I lead the men of the Enlistment Corps. I've heard talk of the Arisen. They say you hold dominion over the pawns. I've ordered pawns to take up swords and fight myself, but they are a clumsy lot. I cannot call them into this world as you do, though, nor make traveling companions of them. What manner of magic lets you command them so? Well, it matters not. The dragon is come. I'll welcome any help. Be it pawn, Arisen, farmer, or fishwife. Make use of the encampment as you please. Are you in need of rest? As you will. Repose is the better part of readiness.
Thank you. am impressed.
Oh, damned! Is your handiwork? For truth? Oh, what is the likes of an idol doing here anyway?
Ancient tales of the Arisen are well and good, friend. But make a gift of these hands to the Duke, and you might earn yourself a real title.
Arisen. I see better now from whence the legends arose. Good judgment, swift footwork. Impressive, truly. In any case, the Duke will want to know of this attack. I'd hoped to gather a larger force before leaving for the capital. But a Hydra's head and the Arisen who claimed it make up the difference amply.
I cannot say what the past may hold. You'll need your strength. It will be slow going with the cart. I dare say you'll have no trouble catching up. We'll meet at the Way Castle. Till then, I bid you rest well. It is a long road ahead.
Well, Ster?
That terrible creature. I saw it from my spot at the post. What was it? It's been dispatched then? Thank the Maker. Hold a moment. Is Kina not with you? She was said to lead the village in search of art for your wounds. I thought you accompanied her. These are dark times for a girl alone in the wilds. Any idea where she might be off to?
We'll need Kina's help for this. Let's ask at the village.
Hold, Minnow. I'd have your ear a moment. It's been a full sun since last I saw Kina. She spoke of the witchwood to find a cure for your wound. If she's gone there for true... I beg of you, find Kina and see her back safely, ere some ill befalls her.
There, just ahead, Master. A woman. The forests of Seven Grances are ever shrouded in this thick mist.
Oh, what are you doing?
You came searching for me?
Forgive me. I would never wish to worry you. But I had to come. A witch walks these woods, one who understands the language of the dragon. If I may find her, I will beg her aid in healing your wound. Will you accompany me? This fog bodes ill. I would walk easier with you at my side. I now know why they named this forest Witchwood, and not just after her, you see.
The fog is thick. Take care not to lose your way. How thick this forest.
The wood is uncommon dense, almost as if it means to hide or to way.
Wolves!
Let's go find more of Mr.'s legacy here.
Struggle as best you can!
Please, pull it down!
This looks interesting.
Keep well clear of those fangs!
Strength in numbers, Arisen.
It's been an age since the witch last visited our village. In truth, I can't be certain she lives here still. Yet even should we find her vanished, we must keep faith. There must be aught here, some small clue.
It's a strange place, this. Is this what we seek? Then this is the witch's cottage?
There. That must be it. Come on, Kaz.
Begging your pardon, but we seek the witch of these woods.
Oh?
A great and aged woman? Perhaps you might have seen her?
The witch?
You seek grandmother? Your grandmother? Yes. Where might we find her? I would ask her aid in a dire matter. She is dead. She died, as all must. Oh. What of you, then? Know you aught of the dragon? Can you read the worm speak? Gran told me. Faith knows. It cloaks the dragon, cloaks the truth. Those who search for truth outside the faith are branded heretic. So your grandmother told you not of the dragon, that the faith might leave you be? Yes. Then it seems we must turn to the faith if we are to learn more. You have our thanks. We'll leave you in peace to return to our village.
Kina is safe. Thank the Maker. Pray, forgive her. If she acts the fool, 'tis only 'cause concern overwhelms her sense. She's like you in that, always setting off without so much as a thought. Most like the fault of ill parenting, which makes the blame mine then, eh?
I trust you rested well, given the hour. The Arisen arose late this day, eh?
We make for the capital, men. Like as not, the cart will draw beasts along the way. Stay vigilant. But fear not. We walk with the Arisen, slayer of Hydras.
I feel more familiar with this quest now.
Let us go!
Allow no monster to approach the cart.
Chances, men. Cut them down on sight.
Are you unharmed, Master?
Monsters arisen! Ready yourself!
Stay at the cart's side!
Grand Sorin is beyond
the I only hope
this palace is a nest for every manner of foul beast, Sir Arisen. No man can say from where they will strike. Pray, be careful.
They come from above. Ready yourselves.
We cannot allow it flight.
Beware the harpy song.
I strike with fire before it recovers.
You must keep the ground.
I have it.
I've learned of beasts.
Now, bring fire.
Have we the means to shoot it down?
Let the harpy sing! I'm hold of one! Now, strike!
That was hardly a warm-up.
A fiend with a woman's form!
The land here is meager, unfit to sustain fiends.
Fire!
We're in striking range!
Our strength brought us victory.
The creatures come! Cut them down, men!
I've learned a new way to fight their ill.
Goblins ill like
a fallen goblin is an easy mark.
There must be
another way.
We're
off! It's a snow under them!
in numbers, Arisen.
We'll not hold them long!
Watch for a goblin ambush ahead, Arisen.
Goblin!
Grand Sorin, capital of Grancis. Shall we enter?
We've arrived. Well done, men. A Hydra's head is a fine prize. His grace will be pleased with the Corps' work. Walk proud through these streets, men. We are heroes to the people of Gran Sorin.
I'll make for the castle directly to offer my report to his grace. I'll have word sent for you, friend. Pray, sojourn in the capital a while.
To the castle main! Step lively!
Ah, fortune smiles upon me. Well met, Sir Arisen. I am called Meso, if it please you. Now you're come to the capital a conquering hero, you'll be needing aught to do, eh? My word to you, begin with the pawns. Inquire about them here in Gran Sorin. Their kind's woven tight into the fate of the Arisen. If you know your destiny, know them.
State your business. Pawn Guild, is it? All right, through here and to the left. Just don't make a nuisance of yourself, eh?
Welcome, Arisen. We have awaited your coming. This pawn is called Barnaby. I tend to the affairs of the Pawn Guild. The guild serves as a place of rest for pawns, and as the gate to the Everfall. The Everfall lies beneath Gran Sorin. It is a place of great importance to our kind. But for now, let us rejoice in the coming of the Arisen, the light that guides the Legion. It grieves me to burden you, weary from the road as you must be, but I fear trouble brews. I would beg your assistance in this matter, Arisen, if it please you. You have my thanks. Beyond lies the Everfall, an ancient place that sleeps beneath Gran Sorin's stones. We pawns have long served as keepers of the entrance to this place. But since the dragon's coming, a strange aura has filled the Everfall. A presence. If it be some omen of evil to come, we cannot allow it to go unchecked. I ask that you seek out the cause of the change, or some proof of what's happened. The Everfall is a place unique unto itself. This is not a simple task, nor a favor I ask lightly. Which is why I ask you, Arisen. Please, lend us your aid.
None would believe Grand Sorwyn held such a place beneath it.
A light. In the furthest depths, you say. I see. In truth, even we pawns know precious little of the Everfall. I can say with utmost certainty, though, the light you speak of is newly come. We cannot know if this small aberration will give rise to great calamity hence. But the chance enough is called to take action. We shall redouble our efforts here. And keep vigilant for further signs of change.
Are you the Arisen? I bring a message from the Duke himself. His Grace has judged your feat in slaying the Hydra most laudable. To honor your noble works, you are hereby welcome to the Worm Hunt. You may now accept orders from Sir Maximilian, Captain of the Hunt. Bring this writ to Sir Maximilian outside the castle gates. He will instruct you further. That document confers the status of hunter upon you. Carry it on your person, always.
Ah, Arisen. My men have told me much of you. I've expected your visit. I am Sir Maximilian Eisenstern, captain of the hunt, so named by His Grace Duke Edmund Dragonsbane. I beg your forbearance whilst I detail what is expected of you in the hunt. The worm hunt license you carry permits the bearer to undertake the most vital of tasks. Those missions given by Duke Edmund himself. Of late, all our will is focused on learning of and defending against the wicked dragon. A weighty task, to be sure, but one which the fate of the realm and its people rests upon. I am under orders to lend Arisen all reasonable aid as they might require. I would pray you return this assistance in kind. Many hopes are pinned upon you, sir. It would be my honor to show you the ready charges for the worm hunt. The choice is yours. Certainly. Then here are the details. By the Duke's decree, we spare no effort in gathering knowledge concerning the worm. As one arm of that pursuit, we aid the faith in their examination of ruins and relics. One such ruin has of late become home to monsters. We've received a request for escort. They've asked for you by name, sir. What response might I give them? My thanks, sir. His Grace has commanded the utmost attention be given to such matters. Pray, speak to Father Geoffrey at the cathedral in the city for details of the task. Were the decision mine, I would set every man we have to defending our strongholds. But such is our duty.
Well met, good Arisen. 'Tis a heartening boon to have your assistance in our endeavors. I will not keep you long, for the survey party has already set out from Gran Sorin. They walk south to the ruins of the falls, near the encampment. I know not what dangers await there, but I will rest easily knowing you accompany them. Pray fly now to their side and keep watch over them. Make her speed your steps, sir.
Oh, make her be good. Are you the Arisen, sir? I am of the party sent to survey the ruins. I've seen no sign of Brother Jean. He had gone on ahead. I dearly wish I could run to his aid, but as you've seen, I am the Faith's greatest craven. I beseech you, sir, find Jean within and see him safe.
I feel more familiar with
this
question.
We'll meet when you are ready, Master.
Soaked to the bone!
Scholars of the Faith gave the Water God's altar its name. It was a place of worship and training. The hearts of the old gods.
Reach!
I see. I do not wish his death to be in vain, sir. I will do all I can. Please, might you survey these ruins in his stead, Arisen? That he may know some small comfort in seeing his work here completed, I ask your aid, sir. Such as these often house engraved slates and other ancient texts. Some have held revelations of vast importance. If you see any within, pray, bring them to me. Oft times, age will splinter the slates. It is critical you retrieve every piece of the whole. As the slate is joined together, the text becomes clear. I will not rest until its meaning is deciphered, sir, for the sake of Brother Jean. The faith will see it done. In that you may believe. You have my thanks, Arisen. I shall break the sad news of Brother Jean's sacrifice to Father Geoffrey myself. It was no fault of yours, sir. You've done your duty by us well, as the Father shall hear. Pray, do not let it weigh upon your heart. Go and tell Sir Maximilian of our success.
You have my thanks, sir. Terrible thing what happened to that monk. There was naught for it. The faith, as all humankind, are victims in the madness wrought by the dragon's coming. That fear of the worm should drive a man to die in pursuit of old stones. I forget myself. At day's end, the Duke has gained more of the knowledge he so ardently seeks. 'Tis a victory.
Hail, friend. Been some time. Trust you've been well? But come, if it was idle twittering you'd wanted, you'd have sought a prettier bird than this old crow. Crows bring tidings, most oft grim. Me, I bring you work. Still grim, I'm afraid. Well? Salvation again, naturally. Nowadays word they've a man inside the castle. If that be true, he'll have need to leave the castle eventually to meet with the others.
All I ask is that you keep watch. If you see someone leaving the castle, shadow them. I only have need of your eyes. Follow them and see what business has them out. I'll do the rest. Skulking about is more my line than yours, I know. But pray, lay your chivalry aside this once. I'd do it myself, but there's aught has me away from Grand Sorin for a time. Nothing for it, I fear. Tell your findings to the innkeep. We have an arrangement. Tread carefully, friend, and quietly, what's more.
Just what is this scrap to you? Oh! Loose those lips and might be our repay in kind. Oh.
Good work. I bid you good day.
Let us tell the innkeep of what we've seen.
What business could Madeline have with that knight? And in secret, what's more.
Oh, it's you. Mason told me to expect you. If you've a message, I could relay it. The night then, is it? Fine then. I'll pass the word along.
It would be my honor to show you the ready charges for the worm hunt. The choice is yours. Certainly. Then here are the details. We have urgent word from the stone of the southwest. A horde of goblins struck the fortress while it was still under repair, and they've claimed it. Though the hold is remote, its importance to our southern defenses is critical. We must reclaim it, and soon. The safety of the entire duchy rides on this matter. I would ask your help in resolving it. You have my thanks, sir. I shall send word to the hold presently. I've sent some of the Duke's swords on ahead already. Meet them there and lend them your arm. I await good word of your success.
By the looks of it, it is a grand and sturdy fortress. It is known as the Shadow Fort, built to ward against a goblin invasion. We're here.
Sir, I take you for the Arisen.
Sir Maximilian informed us of your coming. By your leave, I would ask you spearhead our force here. Our tactics are as such. We aim to strike from the front gate, but lack the time and means to batter down the doors. I ask that you pass through the hole you see there, and lay open the gate from within. I cannot say what may await you within. The danger is great, but I trust you will prevail.
There's a way down here.
I've learned of this area. I shall restore your helm. Hold on.
Tis false!
Goblin!
Common goblin!
Stupid human!
Tides turn in our favor, friends.
Ah!
want destruction, too. Humans want a dragon. And well, I mean, kill each other. Kill all you like. The end is nigh.
Victory is ours!
Yeah!
All glory to the Duke!
Magnificent, sir. The hold is ours once more. I've sent word of your feats onto the capital. The Duke will be most pleased. As are we all. Pray, accept this token of our thanks and esteem, Arisen. Still, their number was too great. No such horde existed in days past. I fear it an ill omen of things to come. Pray, let it not be too late to stem this tide.
Ah, good Arisen. Word of your victory over the Goblin Horde precedes you, sir. With the fort back in our hands, the south of Grancis is shielded once more. You've quelled yet another of his grace's worries. May your success continue, sir. It will be my honor to show you the ready charges for the Wormhand. The choice is yours. Certainly. Then here are the details. I have important work for you, though some is of a less urgent nature. The task at hand is just such a case. Will you take it on? As I was setting about to find work for you, I came upon this slate. I know not its origin, nor its age, but the writing it bears is old. So old, our men could only read a few words. Dragon, scar, arisen, heart. What little we know, all points to you, sir. Best you should have it. If there's aught of import written there, we need to know. Your task is to find out.
What do I know of the old writings? Less than I know of modern script. And I never even learned me letters. Alas, I'm a man of the sword, not the quill. Ask a scrivener, or a counterfeiter else.
Perhaps the Black Cat's proprietor can read it. He forges such texts, after all.
Someone must know something about this matter. Let's ask around.
Ancient writings? Aye, that's simple enough. If you've the coin, that is. What? Oh, you just want alt red? Let's have a look then. As I said, simple enough. That's dragon there, then scar, arisen, and heart there. The rest is no script, friend, just flourish. This slate's no text. It's a cipher. Like as not, it holds some secret meaning to folk those words relate to. I'm not one of them. I fear that's all I can say, friend.
Dragon, heart, and scar, is it? Does it have aught to do with that drawing? The figure of Hill Figure Knoll? You know it, aye? The man drawn upon the hill north of the capital? He bears a scar across the heart. Or the chest, at least.
'Tis a fair distance to Hill Figure Knoll. Let's prepare well.
Him who knows that I know what he seeks to know, knows it well. While he who knows not what I know, or know not. Congratulations, Odile. You have found the man you seek. I am Or was, perhaps like you, a child of man, bound to the dragon. Well met, young Arisen. I am he who was forged by the dragon. Well met, Arisen of the present day. New forged link in the grand chain. You have come seeking meaning for that slate and the words it bears. There is none. None save that it brought you here to me. My form can be discerned only by the true Arisen. I am the dragon forged. Go now. Tell him that gave you the cipher of what you have heard here.
Not a text, you say? A cipher crafted to bring you to the dragon forge.
I see.
If this man speaks true and is immortal, there's a fair chance he guided his grace as well. Be that the case, his words are well worth heeding, sir. Meet with him as time allows. With luck, he'll lead you to victory as well. It will be my honor to show you the ready charges for the worm hunt. The choice is yours. Certainly. Then here are the details. I fear this task is no simple call to action, sir. It will no doubt take time and a more subtle approach than your other work. Perhaps you've heard of the society they call Salvation. In truth, most of what we know is the product of such hearsay. They are a band of heretics who worship the dragon and welcome the perdition it brings. In the chaos come with the worm's arrival, their influence has grown. Ill news indeed. Pray, keep watch for signs of Salvation as you go about your business. If you find aught, tell me. Good. I'll rest easier for it, sir.
Asking after Salvation, are you? He'll be one of Mason's friends, no doubt. All too eager, that one. He's been questioning everyone with ears to listen.
I've learned what to do in this quest. Mason makes his
Mason
home
keeps
here
close
in the
track of Salvation's actions. He'll like being near the aqueduct.
Looking for me, friend. Bearing good tidings, I hope. Else here to put me in chains, I'll wager. No. It's Salvation brings you here, aye? I've had cause to ask the good folk of Gran Soren about Salvation myself. Seems I'm cursed with a villain's mien, though. One look at my face stalls a man's tongue dead. Had I your gentle manner, I'd have them singing long and loud, no doubt. Seems to me we share a common goal. Perhaps you'd take on my investigation. Ah, that's grand. Here, take this with you.
We'll like hear more candid talk now with that badge.
The gathering's to take place down in the catacombs, I hear. You'll not find me there. It's far too dangerous a place to brave for a night's diversion.
This leads down into the catacombs.
Within lie the catacombs. Stay vigilant, Master.
What's that?
This looks interesting. Hear that? It's someone speaking. Let's follow that voice to its source. The voice grows clearer.
While we remain, this is material. And as is a Latin musician's soul, that all he
Seems it won't budge. Let's move on.
Tis not to be found in his pleasure. Distraction.
We're nearly there.
It is but pain's shadow, and no less a transient illusion. For the soul cannot find true pleasure in this world. This world, which writhes and struggles against its feelings.
Take care not to step on any stray bones. These are dark times, Drew. Dark indeed.
All souls will forever. Come to join our flock, Arisen. This is the answer, dear Arisen! Unto all things, death and chaos!
What a sight that was. Though I suppose it's the stuff of every day to you, Arisen. I'd thank you to join me for a moment.
The zealots slipped past, but at least we snared this one. An humbler prize, to be sure, but at least he's talkative. No honor among thieves, eh?
It was just a lark. All in good fun. I never gave over to that rot about destruction and salvation. Never.
Just the same, it'd be trouble if we let him go free, now that he's seen the two of us together.
Why? You promised me!
It's all yours.
Elysian spoke
of no choice to make,
said
Arisen.
The Arisen ran counter to the tides. A heretic.
Anytime.
But I see your reasonable sort. The sort like to hear reason. Come, sir. What's
the
to be gained from blood in
is
your
not
hands?
My place to question your judgment. Fallen. Whatever you decide.
There's naught can stay the dragon's fire. What say we await perdition together? There's many a pleasure to indulge in ere salvation
comes. It's your
comes.
Choice to make,
I'll
Arisen.
Gladly furnish the coin. Pray spare me, Arisen, that I may live to see the flame. You'll be well rewarded. Don't be a fool, sir. Surely my gold is worth more to you than my head.
It is a test of your resolve.
It was not my place to question.
No, that we shall follow, whatever you decide.
Vlad are too kind, aren't you, friend? Sparing his life will win you no thanks, least of all from him. Aye, he'll be around to stay your tongue presently. I'd hoped you might assist me further, but I fear you lack the stomach for my work, friend. I'll not have your conscience round my neck for a noose. Our partnership ends here.
Then the gatherings of Salvation did have sinister purpose. Tis a grave shame the Elysians slipped our snare. We shall redouble our vigilance here to keep the city safe. I fear you are as like a target as Grand Sorin, though. Pray, be wary, Arisen. For now, I leave you with my thanks. It will be my honor to show you the ready charges for the Worm Hunt. The choice is yours. This is a high honor, Arisen. See, you do not take it lightly. Here are the details. Wondrous tidings, Arisen. The Duke is to grant you an audience. His Grace wishes to commend you for your valor and your service to the land. Know, however, that any errand you have taken on will be left to another to complete. You will also be asked to return your writ of permission to join the hunt. If you have aught left undone, pray tend to it before you come to see the Duke, sir. I must be clear, your audience with His Grace will put an end to any current tasks, and you will be asked to return your license to the Worm Hunt. Knowing that, are you prepared to see His Grace now? You are quite certain. No tasks left incomplete? No need for the license to the hunt? Understood. Then pray, enter the castle, sir. A guide awaits within to see you to His Grace.
Tonight the Fisher Knight leaves the humble shores of home for the heady depths of Kart. Pray, let this token from humble Festy garner favor with the Leviathans within. Oh, tut tut, no time for thanks, friend. The Duke awaits. Sail on, dear knight, sail on.
I fear your crown outshines my own. By my command, every road in Brancis shall be open to you henceforth as a member of the Worm Hunt. May your efforts help deliver us from the shadow of the dragon. As long as that damnable beast draws breath, I'll fain accept any help on offer.
All through my reign, I foresaw the coming of this danger. And so I gathered men into armies, stones into strongholds. I readied for war. And then you were risen. You came to us, and the dragon with you. Pray, think on the meaning of that, and of your duty.
Arisen, hail, sir. It seems you truly stand apart from the rest of us. Some sneered when I presented the Hydra's head, said it was your feet alone that won it. In truth, I cannot deny it. I had no hand in it. It is plain fact. But what of the enlistment corps, then? What meaning does our fealty hold? I have no answer to give my men. To give myself.
The sovereign of this land ill comprehends the urgency of the danger it faces. This eve's empty pomp is ample proof. All gaiety, without a hint of real concern. I'll allow, 'tis well understandable. A people numbed by two generations of peace cannot be expected to know true resolve. 'Tis a lesson taught by fire and sacrifice. Pray, let his grace learn before the fire takes all. But I ought not speak in such bold terms before his grace.
Ah, the glorious return of the inimitable, the indomitable, the unforgettable! Scratch that last one. Who are you again?
My, my. Apologies, dear warrior. But to see a face austere as the castle walls adorned with... this? Still, 'tis more agreeable than the endlessly dour air of most of my husband's sawn swords. Valor dwells in the heart, after all. The brave ought not need their raiment to speak for their mettle, no?
By decree of the Duke, you are to be allowed free passage into the castle. This right extends only to your person, and you are advised to comport yourself fittingly. A grievous breach in conduct will see you removed from the castle, or worse. You will take your orders from the Duke's Chamberlain, Aldous. Speak to him for further instruction. May the Maker see you on to further glory, sir.
How fared your audience with his grace, Arisen? Aldous Ludric Sorn at your service, sir. I serve as a chamberlain in the Duke's court. As you may have seen for yourself, it seems his grace is unwell. In truth, there is worry enough to make any man's head ache. But I fear he ails of worse than worry. Perhaps I ought not speak further on the matter, for my own well-being. I am charged with assigning royal orders. Tasks of great import issued by the Duke himself. Pray forgive the bother, but I ask that you come to see me here in the castle whenever circumstances allow you to take on assignment. The future of this war is murky, sir. May your efforts help to bring its end into sight. You are to see me for your assignments, and no one else. I speak for his grace on such matters. My word is his. As such, any task deserves your full and immediate attention. Pray, make your choice, sir. No doubt you're aware the roads are ever more overrun with beasts of every stripe. The threat has only worsened since the dragon's coming. Trade has suffered, citizens have died. A company of the land's finest sword hands have been gathered to thin the creature's numbers. It is no perfect solution, but it is a start. I would ask you to join them, sir. There's been no end of reports of caravans bearing tribute bound for Grand Sorin being waylaid by monsters. Among them, the direst threat is posed by the Griffin. It is not a creature easily quelled, but we can ignore it no longer. Hence the company of elites, and now it seems they are prepared to face the beast. They stand in wait outside the castle gate. Go and speak with them for further detail. I fear this may be a long battle, sir. May the Maker be your shield.
I had a feeling you might be our escort. Aye, we are the company of elites you're to march with. Or jest, I know. We'll circle the capital, striking the griffin as we come upon it along the way. We attack when it sets down. It is nothing so clever as to be called a strategy. It will work. If you still care to join us after hearing all that, let's be off.
I've learned what to do in this quest.
Focus. The hunt is afoot.
Duties are sovereign and the worm hunt.
The leads are known. I feel better at ease with a few more men.
Let's begin with that.
Careful! A goblin!
Striking. I grant you ice in fight! It hates fire!
I've learned new techniques against that one. Perhaps a goblin might also serve as bait. That's all. Barely worth the effort.
I grant you fire's blaze!
So this is where we're to meet the beast. We'd best prepare for battle. Let's put the bait out here. It's close! I can feel it! At the tower soon. Guard at the ready, Master. It'd be a small wonder to find anything within such a labyrinth.
Bled deep. Let's put an end to it. Tis the Griffin's hold.
What are you doing? Fight!
There, Master. Snow Hunt.
Beware the Harpy Sword!
Don't let down your guard.
No!
You've gone and felled the griffin.
It joys me to see a well-crafted stratagem bear fruit. Pray, let us return to the capital and give word of our victory at once.
Welcome back, sir. Then the griffin is defeated. Blessed relief, that. All who walk Grancis roads will rest easier for it. 'Tis welcome news, too, for trade. You and the others who fought have my thanks arisen.
Hang her! Hang the witch! She conjures a dragon! Damnable Hexa!
She's in with the dragon! By the Maker!
The rock! It moves! Monster! This is her devilry! Run! Run!
Sorry, Arisen. You share in my troubles through no fault of your own. Some part of me has long known I was, in truth, a pawn. I do not age or die as others. And always I found making my own decisions difficult. Gran gifted me a portion of her very soul. It was a kindness I can never repay. At first, I knew not how to use this gift. But now I have met you.
So, you are Arisen. This may come as a small surprise, but I know well the path you walk. For you see, I myself was once Arisen. And this girl, Selene, was my pawn. The soul of an Arisen cannot but affect their follower. Given time, the pawn will assume the Arisen's very form. This is the bestowal of spirit, or so I named it. I did not grasp the full meaning of this transfer when first I noticed it. But see well, Selene. See how she resembles me? I pray she can soon live her life as a human true. Age and experience separate us, Arisen, but I know you ken my words. Selene is more than born now. She yearns to choose the course of her life, free from the will of others. If you can aid in this, there may yet be a future for her.
My pawn print.
Yes, I see it now. In truth, I had not thought as much. The ways of pawns and humans are so very close.
Can I truly live? Can I be?
learned of the world, you've filled this heart with feelings of your own. Horns are but shadows of life, doomed to forever echo out across the rift. But soon you will be freed of this unending cycle. Then will your horns belong to you alone. Then will you sleep.
It pains me to burden you, busy as you are with the royal orders, but there is aught I would speak of with you. It is a cause of worry, though I speak only for myself and not as Chamberlain. Might I beg a moment? Skeletons have been sighted near the capital these past few days. Elsewhere, I've had no end of reports of secret meetings among the zealots of Salvation. I cannot help but see the two as intertwined, though I have no evidence to prove it. Still, I'll be damned if I allow their kind to go corrupting the minds of good people for want of evidence. Arisen, I ask this as a favor. Will you look into these events and hunt out any thread that connects them? I believe I've learned where the cult meets. I've made note of it on your map. I ask you begin your search there. Go and learn what you can.
Make of this new plan the High Conclave's crafted. I know the aim's to sow chaos, but still, I can't but think it's excessive. Talk is those walking bones have slain three of our own. We're to let such creatures roam the roads.
Aye, if we're so ordered. The rest of the Conclave's design relies on those skeletons to draw off the Duke's attention. I'll grant you their bloodthirst is greater than I thought. It is time to send word to the others. Come, no more doubts, brother. You're to begin work under the Conclave soon, no?
Aye, I'm bound for there now. It is my first time. I was surprised at the summons, truth be told. I've not been with Salvation long. I suppose they trust me. I'll not miss the hellish life of a messenger, I'll tell you that.
We ought to confront or follow one of them.
You! How long were you there? What did you hear?
The skeletons. Damn my luck.
I'll not hang for Salvation. Was only a way to earn some coin in the first place. They pay a tidy sum for finding new believers and sending them onto the Conclave, though I suppose my hand in that ends today. Let's be civil here, friend. We're not enemies, you and I. Surely we can strike a deal that benefits the both of us. Like, say, I give you a special bit of merchandise in return for a stack of coin. Well, will you help me put this dark business behind me? Hold! Pray hold, friend! Very well. You've made your point. Here, the key is yours. Do as you please with it.
This leads down into the catacombs.
Judge from the beasts that dwell here, the place...
I haven't spoken a word. Not a word, I swear it. You must believe me.
We can use the key.
I had no idea that was the Arisen. How could I have... Please!
Don't allow them to swarm! Ha! See how they falter in their attack!
Cannot be any that were targeted or risen online. man's voice.
You! 'Tis not over with them, fool. Hurry and find the one controlling them further on. Go and...
Welcome, Arisen. It is an honor to have you come so far to meet us. You here seeking the source of the skeletons? Or have you just come to rid us of a few traitors?
My thanks, by the by. I see no call for secrets. It was Salvation loosed those bone warriors upon the land. They are an experiment, a vanguard. All in preparation for the day of reckoning to come. You shall have an honored place among them, Arisen. Aye, your bones shall lead the march as the Red Dawn breaks.
Catacombs are cleansed of rats, thanks to your efforts, Arisen. The roads, too, are all but free from the skeleton warriors. Grancis is safe for the moment. Documents they left behind shed some light on Salvation's actions as of late. It seems the skeletons were an attempt to bolster their numbers, a thought I do not relish. What's more, it was their own members' bones they put to use. Newly joined believers made living sacrifices. They were turned from flesh to living bone by some dark art, all as a part of some experiment. The writings claim that bone warriors wrought from living men are stronger than those come from corpses. Even for a cult of madmen to visit such atrocities upon their own, it is a horror. And one now hopefully at an end. Again, you have my thanks, Arisen. Pray, accept this small token for your efforts.
You are to see me for your assignments, and no one else. I speak for His Grace on such matters. My word is His. As such, any task deserves your full and immediate attention. Pray, make your choice, sir. You've a stake in this, and a right to hear, sir. You know of Fornival, aye? He is among the wealthiest of Grand Sorin's merchants. Though now he stands to lose all. He is accused of a litany of crimes. I would beg a favor, if you've the time. It seems Fornival was as busy in his underground dealings as in his honest work. His bill of crimes includes bribery, fraud, abduction, the selling of secrets, even collusion with Salvation. The inquest continues as we speak. Should the present tide prevail, he will likely be found guilty, and put to death. Opinions are split, however, on the credibility of the present proofs and testimonies. A few days yet remain before the matter is decided. I ask that you go and gather what facts you can. Any proof is welcome, be it evidence or testimony, aught that clearly shows his guilt or innocence. Justice must be done, and for that, we've need of the truth.
Blustering fools just barged in, eh? Hold me prisoner like some common criminal. It is madness and base insult. You there, you're an insult. There's time yet before my trial is decided. Pray, arrange for my acquittal however you may. If you see me through this storm, I'll sell to you at cost for the rest of my days. It is a generous offer, eh? Now go, and pray put an end to this farce. I'm eager to be quit of this confinement. Please, sir.
Tell me, sir, what is to become of my father? You're the Arisen, are you not? Can you not do aught to help him?
I could not bear to lose him. Even if the things they say were true, I still... He was ever a kind father to me. A petition? Of course, I would gladly draft one. I would draft 100 if it be a help.
What? Furnival stands trial? 'Tis a pity. In truth, the man was profligate. His ostentation earned him envy and enmity in equal parts. But he was not the sort of man to seek profit in the misfortunes of others. I will add my name to the petition. I shall pray that his innocence is proven.
I hear old Furnival is the subject of an inquest. His conviction would bring me no joy, not least for the loss of revenue I would suffer. Arisen, I have a proposition, sir. I've long had dealings with Furnival and want to believe in his innocence. Pray, take a petition for his acquittal from me, that it may help sway his arbiters.
I've heard tell that Furnival stands trial. None's the pity. I fancy myself the forgiving sort, but I'll not mourn his passing. I'm scarce the only one he's wronged, either. The man built his fortune on the backs of honest folk. I'll gladly add my name to a petition, if it means no others need suffer at his hands.
Furnival's met with an inquest? 'Tis past time the law caught up with that rat. I'll not forget the pain he caused me as long as I live. The caitiff put my house to ruin. I shall sleep better o' nights, knowing no others will suffer the same fate. Let him rot. I gladly commit my name to the petition for his conviction.
I heard of Furnival's inquest. Serves a lout right, says I. I'll sign any petition you set before me, if it means he'll hang for what he's done. He deserves no better after what he did to my family.
The messenger brought word of Furnival's trial. More's the pity. He finished our arms at quite the favorable rate. We'll be as cats without claws, should he be kept from doing business. I do not know the man well, but I cannot stand idly by and see him convicted. Testimony given in person will carry more weight than a missive. Yet I cannot leave this place. Pray, take one of my men with you back to the capital. He will speak in my place. You do Furnival a service, sir, and us with him. I will send word ahead for a man to await you. Pray, speak to him directly.
I'm called Castor. Sir Dario has informed me of my duties. I'm thankful to have you accompanying me to the capital. Shall we be off? Very well, sir.
Order! I will have order! This inquest has its conclusion. Furnival Frescobaldi, in the name of His Grace, Duke Edmund Dragonsbane, the court hereby proclaims its verdict. Not guilty. You are cleared of all charges and released from bondage forthwith. The inquest is hereby ended.
Word of Furnival's verdict has come. He was judged innocent somehow. 'Twas an acquittal hued in shades of grey, scarce different from black. But an acquittal nonetheless. The trial was fair, and so we must accept its decision. Though the matter ended sourly, it's by no fault of yours. Take your wages with my thanks, Arisen.
Arisen, sir?
Beg pardon, sir? I bear a message from Milady Eleanor. She would speak with you, sir, in private, if you please. Some would raise an eyebrow at such a request, given Milady's vows to the Duke. I trust... Forgive me, Arisen. I must learn to hold my tongue around proper company. Pray, find me tonight in the castle gardens.
praise the Maker you've come, Arisen. Oh, this is glorious, most glorious. Pardon me, sir. Forgive the ramblings of a handmaiden on a strange errand. It's only... Milady's request to see you is a rare thing, you see. First in all my years with her, in truth. I trust you understand the delicacy of the situation. Milady is a married woman, I need not remind you. And well, yes, even innocent conversation could be bent foul were it discovered by others. Pray, walk softly, Arisen, and have a care to let none find you visiting Milady's chambers.
My warrior has come for me. You must think me a shameless harlot. Would that words could prove my love is pure.
Off to a nice siren after a long day's ruling, sire?
No, you must hide.
There is a boldness that fell that dragon.
Quickly.
You storm my lady's bedchambers with the urgency of a man in battle.
Fear not. I shan't eavesdrop on the ducal proceedings. I remain to stand watch and make a guard, sire. For your protection, of course.
My Lord Edmund, would you had mentioned your coming, I might have dressed more finely.
Lenore! Oh, my love! Forgive me!
My Lord Edmund! Is something...
Lenore! Forgive me! I was wrong! I take it back, Lenore! I'm sorry!
Sneaking off to her chambers for a cup of tea. Must be a fine tea. What to come all this way in the dead of night? Or perhaps you seek refreshment of a different sort, like a turn in the sheets with his grace's own wife. Damn, you're tougher than you seem. Perhaps there's aught to this Arisen business after all.
cannot ask forgiveness for this betrayal. But I was certain the Duke would cut me down where I stood had I not spoken so. You must run. The Duke is half mad in fearsome wrath. I shall think of some way to assuage him.
Many within the castle praise your bold deeds of late. I pray such good works continue apace. I've more tasks that require your attention. Pray, make your choice, sir. I'd a task I wished entrusted to you, sir. But Sir Mercedes insisted it be hers instead. She was most adamant. Though she is a knight come in good faith to aid us, she remains daughter to Hearthstone's lord. It does my heart no ease to see her undertake such a dangerous errand. Alas, in the face of her ardent petition, there was naught I could do but accede. Can I ask that you at least accompany her, sir? She must be kept safe. My thanks, Arisen. Pray go and speak to Sir Mercedes.
I take it you've heard. Then you'll know that this task is mine. I'll not be an idle burden on the Duke's hospitality any longer. And surely you've won enough glory, sir. Allow me this one chance to prove myself. You have my thanks. This matter concerns Lord Julian as well. There is talk of dark happenings at the Stone of the North. Lord Julian's watch. He set out for the hold himself some time ago. But there has been no word since. Someone must go and see what has become of him. As a fellow guest of the Duke's, I felt it my duty. I would forbid you from interceding, but you no doubt have your own reasons for going. I will not stop you from joining me, but neither can I wait. Follow if you wish, sir. I am off.
We've arrived at the Duke's northern stronghold. Sir Mercedes to be atop the hold. Who works to impress them here? You're more familiar with this quest now.
Colluded with Salvation to work sedition among the Duke's men!
Salvation? You place me in ill company. I'm a man of this world. Fantasies of death and redemption concern me not one whit. Now, legends. Legends stoke up the masses. If Duke Edmund were to best a second dragon, Francis would take the Ascendant. But her neighbors ill want a giant looming at their borders, am I wrong?
Spare me your sophistry! The word neighbor sours on your forky tongue. Our lands have long sworn unstinting aid to any neighbor beset by the dragon.
Unstinting, you say? Tell me then, why has your Lord Father not sent your brother, joined by Hearthstone's finest steel? Why am I speaking instead with a bleating she-goat mocked even by her own men?
You will retract those words, sir!
Else suffer what consequence?
Else I shall wash my honor clean in your blood!
And you? You will play her second? I would welcome the Jalar.
Stay out of this! He's made an open mockery of me and my homeland! I had thought, and I trusted you were above the base treasons of Salvation's like. The Knight's champion. An earthbreaker of your ilk is champion to no man, Julian.
Salvation? Damn's a lot of them. And their idle talk of destruction and redemption. They were convenient to my purpose, nothing. The day of Edmund Dragonsbane is past. He will not slay another worm. So what cause is served by sending men to die for his pleasure? The swift death of Francis is the greatest mercy to our neighbors.
And what of those of this land who will die for your peace? Will you stand idly by while a people lose their land, their very lives, to a plague of beasts? You are no knight, villain!
Pray, think of the morrow. The dragon will come again. To your homeland, and to mine. Who shall stand against it then, if we are spent, all of us, for having held to some ancient past? What is gained by all our deaths? Naught, I say, and naught would say your Lord Father.
How dare you, sir! I will not suffer such slander!
Know it to be true. Has he sent his finest blades? A general fit to lead them? No, he sent an ornament, so she be too daft to see it. 'Tis an empty show. Your head is a meager trophy. The men of the fort may have use of you yet. Even a she-goat's skin can warm a desperate man o' nights.
What? He's no slander beneath you!
The duel is well and settled, Arisen. Be gone from my sight at once. I've no more patience to indulge your play at knighthood, little girl. Your failure to quell the revolt is cause enough to run home to Hearthstone, tail twixt your legs. I tell you this in the spirit of mercy. If you cannot best me, you cannot best the dragon. Run along home while you yet live. Do you think me cruel, Arisen? 'Tis a sorry truth that righteousness is a rare luxury in war. You are pledged to slay the worm, and that alone. No oath binds you to the Duke, nor would my death do you any great service. There are those might call me a monster, but I am no dragon, sir. What say you?
Pitiable sight. I knew. I am a meager choice to send as aid. I know it well. Still, I could not. I fear I put on a shameful display. Lord Julian had the truth of it, every word. I am weak. I serve no purpose here, save as hollow homage to an empty pact. Aids in name only. Hearthstone or Grancis, there's not a man in either who expected anything else of me. I knew it well enough, tasted it on every breath I drew. Yet still, I fancied myself a knight. Arisen, I will return to Hearthstone. Not to lick my wounds, but to petition my Lord Father that Grancis' people receive true aid. I will not send you to meet the dragon with their fates weighing upon you. After, I shall return here to aid you however I may. I am a fool. Pray, accept this token. I haven't much to give, but it would please me to know it provided you some small comfort on your journey.
It seems the Stone of the North stands quiet once again. You have my thanks. It was an ill surprise indeed to find Salvation's reach extend so deep within our ranks. It is a testament to the rising fear within the people's hearts. We must be vigilant against such corruption, lest the duchy rot away before the dragon ever comes. Many within the castle praise your bold deeds of late. I pray such good works continue apace. I've more tasks that require your attention. Pray, make your choice, sir. It grieves me to report an item was stolen from the castle's stores a few days past. It was a possession of the Duke's and a treasure of the realm, the Worm King's ring. The band was stolen under heavy watch. I fear it to be the work of someone within the castle. But first, the ring must be reclaimed. Will you do it, sir? You would do well to begin by asking the men and women of the castle what they know. That ring is a treasure to all Grancis, and a symbol of the Duke's authority. It must be found.
Good Aldous told me there's been sign of thieving within the castle. Even should they escape sight, the castle's construction hinders all who do not know it well. Our villain had a guide, or had some occasion to grow familiar with the castle.
I heard a report of an unfamiliar man seen within the castle's halls. They say he had the look of that sorcerer.
If there's talk of a sorcerer, it'll be Solomon, no doubt. I'd hoped we were rid of that rat for good. I do not relish the thought of his return. But the pilfered ring does bear a strong magical affinity. Is the sort of bauble Salamet would covet.
Salamet. It is a name that calls up bitter memories. Time was, the Duke held a council of magic scholars here in Gran Sorin, tasked with ensorcelling grimoires and trinkets. Salamet sat at the head of the council. His genius was unmatched, save by his ambitions. Once their research bore fruit, Salamet betrayed his grace and fled with the findings. He disappeared, leaving the corpses of his fellow scholars in his wake. I know not by what design he would reveal himself now. Perhaps aught about this ring that compels him.
A sorcerer, eh? Can't say as I've heard tell of. No, wait. There is rumor going around of a quill-addressed man skulking about the quarry. More than his dress is odd if he's hanging around that place with no reason.
Salamet is an infamous archmage. He's often been seen in the ancient quarry. Someone must know something about this man.
Salvation lets us go champion.
The capture swirls within the ruins.
Well, well. The Arisen, toast of all Gran Sorin. Does the work of all mankind's savior truly afford the time to go hunting petty thieves? If you insist on a game of cat and mouse, what say we see which role you'll fill?
Majesty!
The cat has claws. And more red than a fool's in the Duke's guard outrun. But alas, I'm not the time to gain, sir. Farewell.
You fought him then? I knew it was his doing.
It is a shame he slipped the noose. We cannot allow him to run free. We must see him stopped and the ring returned before he can work more evil.
Do you know of the Blue Moon Tower, friend, to the northeast? I heard a strange tale from a fellow merchant a few days past. Seems there's a man's been seen coming and going round there of late, all the way out there. What's more, they say he's chased off all the beasts nested there with some arcane magic. It's him, says I, that sorcerer they say stole some bauble from the Duke. What was it?
A tower standing in such remotes.
We're here.
If what I've heard holds true, we'll find the wizard here. Make our way upward. 'Tis the only likely spot. We cannot allow him to flee with the ring again.
Armed bandits are risen! Insolence! They are left exposed after a grand strike!
Just wait.
We attack in quick succession!
Salamet is sure to have laid traps for us.
He must be above. Onward, Master.
Truly, the Arisen is a profession given to leisure. Or do you hope to earn your meals catching stray wizards for fear of actually facing the dragon? Alas, I'm not one for company. Let us be done with this. Come to your journey's end! Wormping's ring is a talisman of incomparable character. A vessel worthy of housing your full divine magic. What sublime bliss! What petty rapture! Yes, I will see my dream flame reality.
My support!
I have been reborn unto life everlasting!
Talisman!
Remains is to see the ring safely to Feraldus. I feel more familiar with this quest now. The floor's crumbled away in places. Watch your step.
Salawet is here in Grancis yet. That much is certain. Seek out travelers, peddlers, anyone walking the roads. Someone will have seen him. We must find him, and we must have that ring back. The ring is reclaimed. I haven't the words to express my esteem, sir. A talisman of such power must be kept from those who would use it for ill purpose. The Duke will see it well guarded, and the faults in the castle's security mended. Pray let this lead us all to take greater care in the future. For now, you have my thanks. What? Very well. I shall see to it at once. A matter of a most pressing nature has come to us. Make for the southern Waycastle immediately. I've received a report that one of the Duke's men has returned from afar, gravely wounded. He asks to speak with you, in all haste, Arisen. 'Tis odd his message was not writ in the report. An oversight brought on by haste, no doubt. Pray, fly to the Waycastle and hear the man's message, sir. Meanwhile, I am to see the Duke on another matter no less urgent. 'Tis a restless day.
Arisen, urgent word from the capital, sir. You are to return to Aldous Society with all possible haste.
Not without its dangers. Best we remain cautious, Arisen.
All ready for battle?
Arisen, Maker be good, you've returned. Just after you'd left, a slain cockatrice brought as a trophy for his grace came alive. The beast was well and truly dead, I'll aver it. Brought back by some dark art, no doubt. The local folk have fled to safety, but the beast's rampage is like to destroy the other freight. That tribute is the Duke's own property, sir. That creature must be slain, and quickly.
Grand Sorin, the beating heart of all Grancis.
The Fogifris must be stopped! Protect the remaining chests!
Where it's warm.
What damage have I wrought in carelessness to allow an agent of salvation through? And in sending you away afore the creature was revived, the damage was all the greater. While I, in my fool credulity, ran to the castle, only to be knocked insensate by some villain. 'Twas a lucky thing the beast was kept from the residential quarter. Ugh, or the castle. We must rethink the practice of tribute to prevent such a happening again. For now, though, the danger has passed. What of the damages?
Order has been restored, though not without casualty. A few of the trophies were lost, an unavoidable fate given the circumstances.
No doubt. You have my thanks, Arisen. Your aid spared us greater loss. The beast is slain as well. In truth, 'tis fine work. Still, I know you capable of greater feats. May your next victory be grander still.
Thanks, the Maker, you yet live. I have not the words to apologize for your suffering. The Duke was furious at the news of our actions, as I'm sure you might imagine. In his rage, he banished Milady Eleanor to the lonely northern manse. Now she fears her husband will have her killed. Her very life is in jeopardy, Arisen. We must take our next move before his. We plan to flee and seek refuge in our native Meloir. Please, Arisen, make for the manse and find the Duchess, else she find an assassin's blade. Rescue her. I have a set of soldiers' equipment I stole away for you. Wear it to enter the manse without attracting the attentions of the guard. Please, Arisen, I beg of you, make for the northern manse with all speed.
There's a structure ahead.
Is the Duke's manse. I suspect you'll steal in most easily alone, Master.
What's this? A new recruit, is it? My shift hardly started a moment ago, but as you're here, I must speak ill of good fortune.
You've truly come for me. I've yearned to see you so, all this time. Received from the Duke. It saddens me to leave you, Arisen, but circumstance permits no other option. Before we part, however, I would beg you one last favor. See me to safety. A Melorian envoy awaits outside the manse, but I've not the wherewithal to escape this place unaided. Please, sir, help me.
Found you!
the main exit is far too perilous. We should take this way.
This place.
I will protect you, Elizabeth. The path splits. There's no
certainty. You tend to the Duchess. They're left exposed after a grand strike. That item is gone.
I need final judgment.
To be quit of this place. Let's be done with dragons and that awful duke. That one deserves to be eaten up. I'll shed no tears when that beast leaves this land in ash.
I fear this is farewell, dear champion. I'll never forget you.
Right, m'lady. Let's be off. Quickly now.
I swear it, my love. I'll never forget.
Hail, Arisen. Good news. His Grace has taken notice of your feats and selected you to lead an expedition. 'Tis a difficult task, but of critical importance to the defense of the front. The Duke was adamant that none would do so fine as you, sir. The journey will take you afar, Arisen. If you've tasks to complete or personal matters to attend to, pray, do so now. 'Tis like you will not see Grand Sorin for some time. Then come. The Duke wished to see you before you set out.
It seems the office of Arisen brings with it equal parts strength and ambition.
I am greatly pleased by your work, sir. I would see you rewarded for all you've done. Come, follow me. I have aught to give you afore you set out. There's no call for humility, sir. Take it. The expedition will no doubt hold its share of dangers. May the Maker speed your steps.
Urgent news, Your Grace. A messenger has come bearing word from the Great War. The hold has fallen to a man calling himself the Leader of Salvation. He's taking captives, and threatens to offer up a grand sacrifice to see the land cleansed.
The expedition will keep, Arisen. Head for the Great Wall at once, and quash Salvation's designs afore they're realized. This matter takes precedence over all others. Now go.
The Great Wall. Was built to keep all manner of beasts from Grancis.
We've arrived. Perhaps we'd best rest a moment before entering.
It is a grander structure than the other holds we've seen.
Some walk here, eh? I was dispatched from the capital to aid in your travels, Arisen. I can offer you rest, or see unwanted goods safely back to the inn in Grand Sorin. It is my pleasure to serve, sir.
Take!
Let's go! No!
tusks from the heart of stone. Break off those tusks!
This looks interesting. I'll take that. Break the magic reason. Soldier, quickly arisen! What's that?
I owe you my life, sir. Thank you. There are still others held below. Pray, free them as well!
This looks interesting.
Arisen.
Sorcerer!
At long last, aid arrives. 'Twas quite a wait, sir. The leader of those zealots made for the floor above. There's a passage here will take you there more quickly. I'll open it.
They attack in quick succession.
There must be a way round behind us. I've been stricken.
Slain? Amazing! Sir, you are amazing! I thought the Arisen little more than the stuff of old tales. How wrong I was. Huh? The door? The door? Oh, of course, sir. I shall open it straight away.
An object
Victoria!
They gathered above, sir. Engaged in some dull ritual from the look of it. Makes my skin crawl just to think of it. And say what they aim to do. I'll open the ring door. Go. And make her be your ship.
Find their leader on the roof, no doubt.
From the storeroom, just the least we can offer you.
Ah, the Arisen. Welcome. It would seem our fates are closely bound. The honeyed sleep of destruction will find this place. And all the world in its turn. Indeed, the coming night ill needs us, its faithful harbingers. Just as you and your hubris cannot hope to stop the divine beast that marked you, before its might, you stand as useless and frail as this ungainly contrivance of brick and mortar. Nonetheless, the trice you might delay the dragon's coming is blasphemy just the same. Reduced to dust. But first they shall peel the flesh from your bones, my dear Arisen. fear I have misjudged the extent of your skill, dear Arisen. I see it was folly to worry of walls and armies while you still live.
However,
it seems my regret will be short-lived. Don't you feel it? The very air dances around us! The long night is come! The dragon's reign at last begins! Merciful winged death! All-powerful and merciless Grigori! Behold, you unrepentant blasphemers! This is absolute truth! This is salvation!
The rantings of an upjump zealot make for tedious listening. His ilk serves no role in what is to come. Only my death will staunch the flood of destruction. A task still far beyond your mean. If you would face me, seek me out, and I shall allow it. But heed the zealot's lesson well. When the weak court death, they find it. Until then, I shall hold your little keepsake safe. Your dragon forged will speak for my diligence in that. The choice falls not to me, nor to the whims of fate. It is yours alone.
The hour is come, Arisen. The door lies open. Seek the temple atop the Tainted Mountain, beyond the Great Wall. At its pinnacle, in the shadow of the world, Keeper of the Endless Ring, you will make your choice. What you there become, only you can decide.
It is a heavy onus the men here bear.
Thank you.
dragon. We're near.
Here, the rite will end, Master. And with it, our vision. Strange Saurians reside in these parts.
Let us walk and wait.
Monsters have made a shambles of this place. Even dragons die. The hour has come, Arisen.
A black Saurian?
Those scales look solid as steel.
The remains of a dragon.
Must be cautious!
It's too powerful!
My strength fails me!
I cannot take this more!
What is your purpose here, Arisen? If you sought to live, you had naught but run and hide yourself away. But then, tell me, child of man, what does it mean to live in truth? To wage war against the passing of days? To pray to the unseen for a few breaths more? To raise grand cities from stone and spawn new life in turn? Mankind has done this, yes, and more. But is the tapestry you weave truly of your own design?
We eat when hungry, and we sleep when tired of eating. We kill them as we want them dead.
Their kind is easy to fathom. They go on living from simple fear of death. Not mankind. Some welcome the end with arms outstretched, while others come to face death incarnate, arms in hand. I ask again, what is your purpose here, Arisen? One path to your survival lies in my defeat. Still my heart, and you stay the coming end. Another path before you is to offer up that which you hold most dear. Abandon all delusions of control. For the price of a single life, I shall leave this land in peace. As my vanquisher, the duchy would bow to you. Wealth and power are sweet anodyne for heartache. You'll not gainsay my terms are more than generous. If it matters aught, the man who rules this land now won that honor through just such a bargain. The decision is yours, Arisen. Now, choose. Called you here to me. It was ever your own feet, your own will that brought you. And now again, the choice is yours, Arisen. Offer up the life of your beloved, here and now, and you shall live as sovereign of this land. Your heart will remain ever in my safe keeping, and with it, your mortality. You would face me then. Tis a fool's choice, Arisen. But better fool than craven. I knew your mind ere you came. Still, I ask this final time. Arisen, will you stand and fight? Your choice is made, Arisen. As you have willed it, so shall it be.
Thank you.
There's a way up here.
I feel familiar with this area now.
rest here within me. As sure as the rest.
Attack when it reads!
Find those bait!
it down.
This battle you have begun sits at the very heart of all creation. We are the axis about which the world turns, Arisen. Time itself flows with your footsteps.
disquiet in my breast will not calm. The captor is fallen. Arisen, Grand Sorin is... The captor has fallen. I've never seen such an ill omen.
Well met, Arisen. We've been awaiting your return. Waste no time on us, sir. The Duke awaits. I fear for the others in the castle besides. Though 'tis small mercy to be spared, only to face this world. Perhaps we'll all be wishing the earth devoured us ere long.
You. You met with the dragon. And don't think for a minute I don't know what you did then. I of all men. No human hands could fell that beast! No. You took the dragon's bargain! You conspired with it to wither me and usurp my seat as Duke! But you'll not be quit of me so easily!
Evil upon this land as upon its ruler! Just look! Upon the hellish wall that gapes where once our city stood! And tell me, this is not the work of the dragon's dark magic? Seize this traitor! At once!
Strike from the rear!
Put this boat to shame, men! His grace commands the original captain!
dead or alive.
Then strike. Find an opening, then strike. It's
time. Recover, Sindulfus. You must away.
Find staring back from this world's utmost depth. If
you would heed my call, prove now your worth. Show that you've the strength to break the yoke that binds you.
I would ask aught of you, Arisen. Please, take this. My mistress gathered their like as she sought her way through the depths. She died as she was done. If you would take up her task, pray bring them here to me. I trust that you will see my mistress' will done. I shall await you further on. Yes, at last. At last you've gathered the whole of them. With them, you can summon forth a rift of considerable power. This rift, born of the Wakestone's power, will guide you forward, Arisen. I fear there will be no returning to this place. Are you prepared to journey on? End this, Arisen. May the world be put right by your hand.
Well met, Arisen. I'll not waste time on rhetoric. Defeat me, and take my place as keeper of this world. You saw it awaiting you at the end of your descent. Aye, the same world you've traveled to arrive at this place. A world you may well now inherit. It is a simple proposition, no different than any you've faced. You need only the will to claim what is offered you. The will to survive. Yes, fight, Arisen,
as you e'er have fought in coming here. What is it that impels you? What force spurs you on? What sustained your wanderings and led you here? I ask, what is it that makes you alive? Tis volition, unbending will. You are here because you willed it, Arisen. That alone has brought you here.
Just as you call forth forms, so I command all life into existence. Call it divine creation if you must, but expect none of the mercy men seek in their gods. This is cold truth, the unbending reality of a world without compassion. The world and all its denizens are but empty vessels. In that regard, no different than the pawns. Without volition, there is no true life. The world falls stagnant, dead as an ocean with no current to guide it. That volition is tempered by the struggle for survival. The decision, just like yours, to fight. Just as the pawns need a master's command, so the world thirsts for the will to live.
Continue. Show that you are more than an empty vessel, animated by forces unseen. Show that the temper of your soul is strong enough to command far more than mere forces. Show that your will is fit to bind the frame circle of this world and hold it fast. Fight tooth and claw. Struggle now and cling to life. Show that living holds worth enough to fight for!
It is time to decide. Will you claim your right as Arisen? Or shrug the burden and seek peace in oblivion? Just so. One foot after the next, come what may. That is what it means to live. Turn back now and I will grant you a merciful death. The choice is yours, Arisen. Yours alone.
Tis a simple choice, Arisen. Step forward or retreat. Accept the quiet emptiness of a false peace, a false life.
Put an end to it. Praises of the quiet life are sung far too infrequent. That's a mite harsh, I. Ever the noble, weren't you?
Oh. There is naught to be gained from my words now. Indeed, heed no voice but your own.
You're not without a home to return to. Why? What is it drives you so?
One of my stature.
Why this hesitation, sir? You've ought to protect, do you not?
Yes. This is your answer, then.
For some, I could not follow. All I ask is death. Me at the side of those I love. All I ever ask.
Close now. So very close to me.
Come, Amazon. I shall meet you on your own terms, joined by my own companions of old. You stand now at its end, Arisen. See your journey through. Upon itself and all the world. So the cycle continues forever and ever and ever.
Now, attack the seneschal!
Arisen, forgive me. All I've done is to test your will. It is the fate of all, Arisen. You and I swept up in the current, same as the rest. Each tempers the volition of the next, and the endless cycle continues. And so, until the coming of a new soul fit to craft the will to live, someone like you. Until that day, may you guide the world ever justly. Present you with the Godsbane Blade. Those who arise to oversee this world are undying, save by this brand's kiss. is the world's new seneschal. Use it now to vouchsafe freedom to your weary servant.
I've given up hope of seeing you again, in any form. It's clear that forces beyond my ken are at work here. But I'll ask no questions. Not today.